Thank you. So we all are in the same boat, aren't we?
Amen.
What a privilege. What a privilege it has been. 2002, I believe. Ms. Crawford, I think that's the first year I was able to come here. I was with Brother Squire at that time. We came from, we came every year. And you know what? Through God's grace and your heart.
Amen.
We've been privileged to be here every year since.
Amen.
There's some consistency there that I tell you, it's more precious than gold to me.
Yeah.
And I just thank God for it.
Amen.
And I thank God for you all. And I desire your prayers, and I want you to know from our heart to yours, you are continually in our hearts.
Amen.
And in our prayers.
Amen.
And I love you from the depths of my heart. And I thank God for you. And I appreciate it so much. You mean the world to us. It's just an honor. So I remember growing up, it was my grandmother that used to sit me and tell me all about Jesus. And that's where I first heard it. And she always made sure we were in church. And I had great parents. I did. They just weren't quite as locked in, And my dad never darkened the church door for most of my life. But he finally, and God finally got to him and just shows you that God's greater and stronger and more persistent than we could ever be. And I thank God for that. But hey, I first learned about Jesus when I was sitting there on my parents' knees. And that's what this song talks about. But I might look different. I look different now than I did then. But, somebody say you know the hill. Well, I'm on my way down probably. But there's a hill I climbed one day and I never got over it. This is what it is.
I first heard about Jesus sitting on my mama's knee. All of our long years, my eyes filled with tears as she told how he died just for me. The years have gone by. I'll break.
yesterday, and Mike wanted to stay in the room and study, and of course I wanted to shop. And so I went to this great place called IKEA. We don't have those in Knoxville, and I wanted to go. Not that I needed anything, but I just wanted to go and look around. And you know, they've got these rooms set up. It's set up like a kitchen and a living room and an office, and it was just the coolest thing ever. And people were just filling their buggies so full. And I got tickled because you come up to this thing that said clearance price, and it was $1.49, and I don't even know what it was, but everybody would run to that bin to look to see what was on clearance. I was one of them, I'll admit, and I might have even put a few things in my buggy. But I started thinking, you know, if you wanted a pillow, it's there. If you wanted a toilet bowl cleaner, it's there, a scrub brush. If you wanted a desk lamp, anything you can imagine that you wanted for your home, it's there. And I got to thinking, if we could set up something like that for Christians or for non-believers, that they could just go to a department store and purchase these things for the non-believer, they would probably buy the store out if they could purchase the things that they needed to be a Christian. But the bottom line is it's already been purchased.
Amen.
It's been bought and paid for by the blood of Jesus Christ. And He has provided everything that we need. For one thing, you can find it all here. You've got a wonderful pastor that you're blessed to have. And you can find everything you need. If you need hope, just open your Bible. It's all in there.
That's right.
If you need courage, it's in there. If you need strength, it's in there. It's already provided. All we have to do is open it up or come here and ask for it. Look for it. Search for it. I searched for IKEA yesterday. I found the street that it was on, and I found it. And I'm so thankful that one day God opened my eyes. And
Yeah.